Again, Bronco Carl 92 here. So it's Thursday, July 3rd. This is just a quick update on the 4L80E saga with Gregg's transmission. So anyway, we put the trans back together. Gregg picked it up. He put it back in the truck last week. And lo and behold, still the same drivability problems, low stall speed, no power out of the hole. So he gave me a ring and told me it's still the same thing, and I said, yeah, you know, Gregg, I think we really need to put the old tune back in there, like I asked the guy about a couple weeks ago. And Gregg felt, yeah, that would be the best thing to do. So he contacted the guy, and the guy was, I guess, kind of hesitant or whatever, but said, nonetheless, send me the computer. I'll put the old tune back in from when he drove down, and you know, we'll see what happens. So Gregg got the computer back Monday, put it in the truck, and the truck drives fine now. So he contacted the tuner and basically told him, well, truck's driving okay now. Just want to let you know, and I think we need to set up another tuning session. And the guy basically came back to him and said, it doesn't make any sense. I don't know what makes any sense. It's what it is. The truck didn't work right with the tune. He obviously made a mistake. So anyway, we'll see what happens when he tunes it again. I think the guy really should own up and you know, maybe give Gregg some money back. You know, Gregg spent $250 for the original tune, and then the dyno session where the truck actually broke. That was another $500. So Gregg's got $750 into this guy, plus the money that we had to put into the trans, my time, which you know, I comped. So anyway, we'll see what happens. And if he doesn't do right, the infamous tuner's name is will be disclosed. I don't have this channel to bash on people, but I think in this situation we might have to let the world know about this guy. So. Anyhow, as always, thanks for watching, and have a happy 4th, which is tomorrow. Take care, guys.